That's not my phone. I turn off my phone when I film. Hey guys, it's Drea. So today I have what I hope is a super fun video. I wanted to do a tag video. And this is an idea that popped into my head about a week ago, and I don't ever recall seeing somebody do this on YouTube, and I did search. So if anybody has ever done this before, please let me know, but I did not see anybody do this before. This is my favorite repurchased items tag. Now, there's no questions. It's just, what are the things that you have repurchased that just make you warm inside? They're just fun things, you love them, they bring you joy. Whatever it is, what things have you repurchased before that you love? Now, of course, I've seen people do, you know, my most repurchased items, but listen, I've repurchased my deodorant 20 times over. It's not one of my favorite things, you know? So this is a little bit of a tweak on something you might have seen before, but it is my favorite repurchases. So I pulled a bunch of stuff here, and honestly, I probably could have included more, but I didn't want this to be totally long. So these are really like the best of the best, my favorite things that I have bought at least once before, maybe in a few cases, quite a few times before, and it is gonna be a tag, so I will tag a bunch of people down below. Let's just hop into it. First thing, I've talked about this a lot on my channel because I've repurchased this an ungodly amount of times. This is the Physicians Formula Eye Booster 2-in-1 Lash Boosting Eyeliner. So it's a liquid liner with a brush tip. That is my preferred method of liquid liner, a brush tip. I love a brush tip. There's something about a felt tip that just doesn't work for me, so I love a good brush tip. This is in the shade Ultra Black, and you do need to get Ultra Black because black is not black, it's gray. This is a total dupe for the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner in Trooper, only it's like half the price, even less than half the price when you get it on sale. It is what I'm wearing today. You can see you can get a very nice, precise wing with it. Love, love, love it. And my other favorite liner ever, like this is my holy grail liquid liner. This is the NYX Matte Liquid Liner. That's all it's called, NYX Matte Liquid Liner. This is a brush tip as well, but it's slightly different in that it is the kind that comes out in a pot, and this is your applicator. Definitely flexible, a little bit even more black than the Physicians Formula one, and it dries matte, which is the difference. The Physicians Formula one is a little bit shiny. This is totally matte, which is why I love it. Both of these like stay all day, waterproof, excellent formulas on both of them. They're both drugstore. They're both drugstore, save your money. One of my favorite mascaras of all time is the Urban Decay Perversion Mascara. There's something about this that if I don't have it, I miss it. It's got like this super messy brush. I really love natural hair messy brushes. There's something about them that to me just gives you so much nice volume. It's a really big brush. I don't know, I like it big, what can I say? And it's super black. It's not the most lengthening. It definitely gives you length, but it gives you so much volume, which is why I love, love, love this. Now I should say, I know a lot of people that do not like this. And I think the difference is if you like a wet formula, you're gonna love this. It's a very wet formula and your lashes stay very flexible. They don't get crunchy throughout the day. And then like some people like a dry formula. I don't really love a dry mascara. I love a wet mascara. So that's why I love this. This is probably like my third or fourth one. Like seriously, my favorite. I've only ever repurchased a lipstick once ever. I've only used up two lipsticks ever. Maybe three. I've used up very few lipsticks, but the only one I ever repurchased is this. This is from Too Faced. It's their La Creme lipstick, and it's in the shade Spice Spice Baby. And actually, looking at it, I repurchased this VIB springtime this year, and look how much I've already used. Like, I just can't get enough. This is my holy grail lipstick of all time. It's just a nice sheer everyday, slap it on, but your lips look juicy and like it's nude. I love a good nude, but it's kind of a warm nude, very shiny. It looks so good. You don't need a lip liner. It makes your lips look luscious. Okay, the next thing I want to throw in, I haven't used one of these up before, but I have repurchased it because I want a backup and I'm scared if they ever discontinue this, then I won't be able to get it again. So I bought a backup, even though I'm not done the first one. This is the ColourPop Pressed Single Shadow in 143. 143 is the text numbers for ILY, for I love you. I have my original in my Z palette. You guys, if you're looking for a real nice matte purple, this is your girl. Now, my favorite matte purple is from Natasha Denona. It's called Nina's Orchid, but the price difference is like crazy. And this one is almost as good. So there's a swatch of it there. Like I said, it is very pigmented, very smooth. It's not as intense as the Natasha Denona one, but it is like, purple is hard to do. I have searched and searched for good purples and they are few and far between. So this one is real good, and we all know ColourPop is like super affordable. So check this one out if you're looking for one, but I'm so glad that I have a backup now. When it comes to eyelashes, I have been known to say this over and over and over again. I like drugstore lashes better than other lashes. I mean, I'm not saying I hate like mink lashes or faux mink lashes or more expensive lashes. A lot of them are amazing, but I just like drugstore lashes. They're cheap. They look great. I don't know, man. I just like them better. So my favorite brand from the drugstore is Ardell. Now, keep in mind here in Canada, there's not as much like variety. We don't have Allure here. There's no Salon Perfect. Even Revlon lashes are few and far between. So Ardell is kind of the most common brand to find, but I really, really like them. So these are the faux mink lashes. I've got the 810s and the 812s here. I think I have the 811s somewhere else in my collection as well. And then these ones here are just your classic demi wispies that have been around forever, but they look so good on. The thing I love the most about Ardell lashes is the flexible band. There's something about some of the more high-end lashes or mink lashes that have that very thick band. It's very difficult to work with. So I just find that these ones with the flexible band are so much easier, and these are so beautiful. Like, how can you not love these? My favorite face powders are both drugstore, and they are both repurchased a couple times over. This one here is from e.l.f. It's the Perfect Finish HD powder. This one is translucent. That's what it looks like there. Obviously, this is a newer one because I have used them up before. Same with this NYX Stay Matte But Not Flat powder. This one is in the shade Creamy Natural. So there are shades in these. Now, this is not like a full coverage powder foundation. I use it like a setting powder or like a repowdering powder throughout the day when I get really oily, which I do. I have very oily skin. And they both work amazing on oily skin. So this one's gonna give you just a little bit of coverage, not a ton. Like, don't worry, you're not gonna be cake face or anything. But if you have oily skin, these are both so, so, so good. I'm so glad to have found these. They help me control my oil so well. Okay, so these are not like repurchases as in I've used them up and had to get new ones. These are just repurchases in the sense that I've gotten them before and love them so much I just need more. And that's some brushes. So this is from MAC. This is the 239, and also from MAC the 242. So I bought the 239, loved it so much, I knew I needed another one, have bought another one, and in fact, I want to get a third. Same with this, the 242, bought it, loved it so much, got another one, want to get a third one. The 239 is really, really good for laying down shadow all over the lid, but laying down like matte shadows more than metallics. It still works with metallic, but for matte shadows, I feel like this gives you a real nice intensity of pigment. The 242 is what I would use more like what I did today when I want to spray something with Fix Plus and get that like intensity of shine or like metal, metallic kind of thing coming through. That's when I use a 242. If you have ever heard of a company that has duped these, please let me know, because I haven't and I am dying to know if anybody has or hopefully ever will, because they're not the cheapest in the world, but they hold up. Like, both of these I've had for definitely over a year and I use them all the time and wash them all the time. So they're excellent quality. Okay, another MAC product. I could not do this video without mentioning MAC Fix Plus. I love MAC Fix Plus. It is so good. It has so many uses. It has an amazing refreshing smell. Like, if you don't love the scent of Fix Plus, go get yourself checked out, because I think it's awesome. Okay, maybe that's rude. You're allowed not to like the smell, but everybody I ever hear talking about it loves the smell. So this is really good for, of course, spraying your brush when you're using eyeshadows wet. It gives you really intense pigment, really intense, you know, for metallic shadows, that kind of thing. But also, this is an amazing setting spray. It's not that it mattifies me, because it definitely doesn't, but what it does, because I have oily skin and I put so much powder on it to like get rid of all the oil, sometimes I can be left looking very powdery and matte, and I don't want that. I want to look natural skin. I want to look you know, like a real person. So whenever I use a lot of powder, I will spray myself with this, and it just kind of melds everything together. It makes your blush, highlight, contour, all the powder, it makes everything look real, like it's part of you. So it gets rid of any of that powderiness, and of course for dry skin, it's good for hydrating. So this is just one of my favorite products of all time. That's it for all the makeup, but I also wanted to include some other repurchases, starting with this. Look at this, you guys. I can't even tell you how many times I've bought this moisturizer. This is from Paula's Choice. It's the Resist Youth Extending Daily Hydrating Fluid, and it has SPF 50 in it. So again, I have very oily skin. I need some moisturization, everybody does. Like when you get out of the shower and your face, if you don't put something on it right away, it can feel like very like, you know, like dehydrated. So I still need some moisture. And that's what this is really good for. It's really good for oily skin. But of course I love it for the SPF. This is what I wear in the morning. I wear heavier retinol products at night, but in the morning, daytime, this is my go-to, and it like makeup goes on top of it, no problem. I've always struggled with SPFs and putting makeup on top. Sometimes you get like a balled up effect and it's just gross, but this is always amazing. And then this eye serum. Now I use this not just as a serum, I just use it as my own eye cream for the whole day because it is so moisturizing. But this is the DCM Hyalamide Sub-Q Eyes. One drop per eye is going to give you plump, just plump under eyes. Like it's just gonna give you hydration for your under eyes. It's really, really great. As far as like anti-aging, I don't really know about the ingredients, but for hydration, it's amazing. I've bought this twice before. This one's almost done. I love it so much. And then I've got a couple bath things here because I just can't get enough of these things, and they're just my favorite. I just repurchased these two, and let me talk to you about them together. So these are the repurchased ones. I'm still working on the ones upstairs in my bathroom, but I will be done with them soon. These are from Nuxe. So this is the multi-purpose dry oil for face, body, and hair. And then this one is the precious scented shower oil, and it has like a golden shimmer in it. These are my go-to in the summer, although I'm gonna use them all year round, but to me these are just like summer in a bottle. Like they smell amazing. They take me back to when I was a child. Something about them, I don't know, it's like a scent memory thing for me, but they just remind me of summertime. The body oil, I use it all over my body after I get out of the shower, especially on my legs. Sometimes I like a lotion on my legs depending on the shower shave cream I use. After I shave my legs, sometimes I need it, sometimes I don't. But regardless, I just love the way this feels on my legs, and it moisturizes and it smells amazing. And especially in the summertime, it gives you a little bit of like luminosity if you're wearing shorts or capris or whatever. And then basically same thing with this. This is kind of like the shower gel version of the oil. It has the same scent. It's just really, really nice. And this one leaves a little bit of shimmer behind on your body. So again, in the summertime, so good. And then last product I want to talk to you about today, I just repurchased this. So this is the first time I'm repurchasing it, but it is one of my favorite repurchases ever. And I can see myself just using this over and over and over till I die. Like, it's so good. This is the Soap and Glory Sugar Crush Body Scrub. And it says with smashed brown sugar and sweet lime. And brown sugar and sweet lime is definitely like the vibe you get off of this. It's got this like margarita lime but sweet scent to it. It's so incredible. I wish we had smell-o-vision. I wish you could smell this. I know sometimes YouTubers talk about scent and you're sitting at home and just like going, girl, I can't smell that, what you doing? But seriously, this smells so amazing. But I also really like it as a scrub because, like, for example, I like to exfoliate my legs before I shave them just to prevent like ingrown hairs and that kind of thing. And this is like the perfect amount of grit. It's not too little and it's not too much where it's hurting you. You ever get like those exfoliators that do nothing and you're like, why am I wasting my time? And then those other ones that are like scraping you up, it's not cool. So this one is just absolute perfection. I love it. So that's it for my favorite repurchases. I hope that you enjoyed watching this. I hope you got some good information. This is just an idea that popped into my head and I thought, you know what? That's a great idea. I would love to like find out what my favorite YouTubers repurchase over and over, which is why I made it into a tag. So again, I'm gonna tag a bunch of people down below, but if you make videos or if you like Instagram or whatever, feel free to hop on this tag even if I don't tag you, because I'd love to see anybody and everybody do that and just tag me on social media and I will check it out. And yeah, that's it for today. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Please be kind to yourself, speak kindly to yourself, especially when you're looking in the mirror. I love you guys and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Again?